everyone, and welcome to Making the Best of It, a daily video series helping you make the best of your time at home. Today is a very special episode that I would like to dedicate to my amazing cousin, Mika. So she is just graduating 8th grade. I am so proud of her. She's going to do amazing in high school, and I can't wait to hear all about it. And I just want to take a minute to congratulate her and really anyone who is graduating this year. I know that things are a little bit different than usual, but it's still awesome that you all have graduated. Now, for today's project, we will be making pinhole cameras. So these are a super cool, fairly simple to make thing that kind of teaches us a little bit about how cameras work. They're also awesome for doing things like looking at a solar eclipse because you can't stare directly at the sun to see them. So they're a really interesting thing to do, and part of the reason that we're doing them is because I actually had two separate people say we should make one for this show. So keep watching to see how to make your own.
Before we get started building though, let's talk a little bit about how a pinhole camera works. So the first thing that you do is choose a subject. In this case, that's the tree on the left. And the light coming off of that tree gets directed through the pinhole of your pinhole camera and goes out behind the pinhole and onto a screen. The image that gets created on the screen is an upside down and smaller image of the original subject. For this project, we'll be using a pen to poke a hole in a cardboard box to use as our pinhole and a piece of wax paper as our screen. A pinhole camera is a type of camera obscura, and one of the amazing things about camera obscura is that they can kind of just happen on their own. So this image that you see projected onto the wall is actually made in Prague Castle, in Prague, because there is a small roof tile missing. And because you have light passing through a small hole, you end up with a projection of the street outside on the inside of a wall. One of the things that a pinhole camera is really useful for is looking at an eclipse, because you don't want to look at the sun directly with your eyes. This picture is an example of the natural camera obscura that is created by tree leaves during an eclipse. You can see from the sliver of light that's coming through just how far the sun has been eclipsed. It's pretty awesome, right? And while the pinhole camera that we are making today isn't going to be able to actually record a picture that you can take away with you, it is actually possible to take real pictures with a pinhole camera. This is an example of a picture taken with a pinhole camera. The top is the exposed negative, and the bottom is the actual picture that was created. If you wanted to, you could replace the piece of wax paper on the back of the camera with a piece of photo paper, and you would be able to get something like this. It can be a little bit tricky to figure out just how big your pinhole needs to be and how long you need to expose the picture, but what a great way to learn something new! To make this project, you will need quite a few supplies, but don't worry, I promise actually building it is pretty easy. So here I have some wax paper, some foil, a pen, scissors, a ruler, I have a box cutter, but you can use an X-Acto knife or you can just get creative with some scissors, a Sharpie, some tape, any kind will work, and a cardboard box. The first thing you'll need to do is take your box and put it back together. So mine was completely flat, so I'm folding in all the flaps on the top, and then using a little bit of tape across the top, and then doing the same thing to the bottom. Don't worry about getting it perfectly closed, we're gonna do that in the next step. Just get it so that it looks like a box again. The next thing we need to do is completely seal the box so that absolutely no light can get in. Now, all of those edges of your box where things fold and come together, those are places that could leak light. So what I'm doing is I'm putting pieces of foil over every edge that might let in some light and taping it into place. Basically, you'll need to put foil on any place where you'd normally put tape on if you were trying to send a package and make it really secure so absolutely nothing could fall out. You'll also want to put foil on any place on your box that might have a little rip or tear if something ran into it and made a scratch. Those places can also leak in light. Now, the reason that we're being so careful and trying to block out all of this light is because photography is about using light to create images, and we don't want our pinhole camera to be capturing any light that we don't want. So the foil is a great thing to use to close up the edges because it's not going to let in any light. In our next step, we'll be adding a pinhole, and that is where the light that we want to use to create our image is going to be coming through. to make your pinhole, the first thing you'll need to do is mark where you want it to be. So turn your camera on its side so that you're looking at one of the short sides of your camera, and then use a ruler to measure out and mark where the approximate center of this short panel is. Once you've found the center, carefully use a pen or pencil to push down on the center mark you made and create a small hole. Then flip your box over and on the other short side, find the center and mark it again. After that, measure out an inch on each side of the center point that you made to make a 2-inch by 2-inch square. The next step is to cut out the square that you just drew. I am using a box cutter. You can also use an X-Acto knife, but if you're using one of those two tools, please be extra careful and make sure that you have either parental supervision or help. You can also use a normal pair of scissors, and what I would recommend doing to get just the center square cut out with scissors is poking a hole in the center, like you did on the other side for your pinhole, pushing the scissors inside of that hole, and then cutting out to get to the edge of your square before cutting out your square. After that, get your wax paper and hold a piece of it over the square that you just cut out. Then take your Sharpie and draw a square that is about an inch bigger on each side than the hole that you just cut out. Now cut out the square of wax paper that you just outlined with a Sharpie. Finally, use tape to carefully attach each side of your piece of wax paper to your camera. Great job! You've just finished constructing your pinhole camera. When using your pinhole camera, you should look a little something like this, kind of like an old-timey photographer. The blanket over top helps keep out any unwanted light and lets you see the image on the screen just a little bit better. You'll need to do all of this in a dark room, though, if you want to be able to see anything. You'll also want to point your camera at a light source. Something like a lamp or a flashlight works best. When making the examples for this video, I actually made a little kind of booth out of a chair, and it worked pretty well. So this is my attempt at taking a video so that you can see what I see through my pinhole camera. I found that the coolest thing that I could find to take a picture of was the twinkle lights that I have down in my basement. So you should be able to see those kind of going by, and they looked really pretty in this pinhole camera. Remember that because the image that you're seeing is upside down and backwards, you're going to have to move the camera in ways you might not expect in order to get the picture that you want. You may also want to play with just how far away from your face you hold your camera, because that will change the focus of your image. It's also interesting to notice that it looks really bright and light in the bottom of this video, but really the room that I was in was quite dark, and it's just the setting on the cameras that are making it look that way.